What is your take on this phase one? Are you for it or against it?
Well, it doesn't matter. They're not going to comply with it. China's never complied with anything. They can say they're going to buy our products. Remember, they said they're going to buy those back in January, and they didn't do it. They've never complied with the WTO, open their markets. They steal our technology. They're intentionally allowing fentanyl to be sold into our country. They said they wouldn't militarize the South China Sea. They did. They are taking away rights, basic rights from Hong Kong citizens. They said they wouldn't. I mean, look, this President Xi is somebody that it doesn't matter what he signs. They're not going to comply. I mean, they've never complied. I mean, aren't we all glad that the president's talking to China? That's great. It doesn't matter. They're not going to ever comply.
Why is the president talking with them then? If that is right, because President Trump certainly is not a softy. It doesn't seem like when it comes to China. He has some people around him like Peter Navarro who certainly are not softies about China. So why are they going forward with this at all?
Hope springs eternal. Maybe they'll change. I don't believe they're going to change. They've not given us any evidence they're going to change. Let's remember, this also, President Xi committed to some terms of a contract agreement earlier this year and then changed his mind. So it's consistent for Communist China. They talk a big game. They never, never, never comply. I hope everybody that's going over there, I know Mike Bloomberg's going over there for a summit. I hope everybody, when they go over there, they bring up the human rights issues because they got a million people in prison just over their religion. They're a horrible human rights violator and a horrible polluter. I hope everybody that deals with China says, stop taking away rights, stop polluting the world.
What's a better approach?
I think we ought to be really direct with them. Say, look, I'm a business guy. How do you get business deals done? First off, you cannot do a deal without trust. When somebody starts negotiating with you, agrees to something, then changes their mind, almost never does that deal happen. China is not trustworthy. You can hope and hope and hope and hope. They've never been trustworthy. So what I think we have to do, when you negotiate with somebody, say, this is what I have to have. If not, look, don't talk to me. Don't waste my time, and I'm not going to waste your time. That's what we ought to do with China. These are the terms under which we will do a deal with you. Stop stealing technology. Open up your markets. Stop putting a million people in jail for their religion. Some basic things like that, and then see if they want to do it or not. If they don't, stop talking.
As a business guy, as you say, you want to assess the leverage. Is the U.S. strong enough to do that by itself, or should it be reaching out for a more multilateral approach, something that President Trump said he doesn't like?
Look, we ought to try to get everybody to do this. But look, whether it's trying to get the Europeans to help us with Maduro down in Venezuela, whether it's trying to get them to help us with Iran, the Europeans have not shown up to try to fight these fights with us. So unfortunately, I think it's great that we try to get everybody to support us, but the Europeans have not really been great partners right now on these issues.
Let's turn to a different subject, Boeing, because you had something to do with that yesterday when we had hearings up before the Senate Commerce Committee. What was your take on Dennis Muilenburg, the CEO's testimony? Were you satisfied?
Well, first off, I mean, your heart goes out to the people that lost their lives in the crashes. And I know the President Muilenburg of Boeing, said he apologized for that. What was important to me is to understand, have they held people accountable, and have they made changes so this won't happen again? So that's what I asked him about. He gave me some answers. I think I still have some more questions, but I think that's what they've got to be very clear to the American public and the worldwide public. What went wrong? Who have we held accountable? What changes have we made so we're all going to be comfortable flying Boeing jets? I think that's what's important. I think they still have some work to do.
We're well into this process at this point, months and months of this process. Why has it taken so long?
I don't know why it's taken so long. Look, I think these big companies, the lawyers, they always tell them, oh, be careful what you say and things like that. And I think I think it's legitimate because of litigation and stuff like that. But I think they've got to be more forthcoming. I know I listened to the CEO yesterday. I felt like he really wanted to make sure Boeing continues to be a great company, and they are. I think he was very apologetic to the families that lost their loved ones. But I think there's still a lot of work to do. And plus, there's a lot of work for the FAA to do to really convince us that their process actually works.
Well, and that was my question. Did the regulators let us down here? Because there was a fair amount of questioning yesterday about the regulators and some of the internal communications that had not been given over to the FAA that indicated they really thought they could spin the FAA.
I think that whenever something like bad things like this happen, you have to say something went wrong. You have to just acknowledge, look, what we thought was working maybe didn't work. So we've got to make a change. And what's important to me, and it's important for all federal agencies, is to say, okay, so people make mistakes. You hate that. But what are we going to do to change it, and how are we going to convince the American public, whether you're a taxpayer or just the American public, whoever you are, that your government is working? So big companies have to do it. Our federal government has to do it. The FAA has to do it.
In this instance, are we delegating too much to the regulated by the regulators?
I think we have to look at that. I mean, if you have to look, our airline safety record has gotten better and better and better. So there's some good things that have happened. But when something like this happened, you have to step back and say, what went wrong and what should we change? Because clearly we have to change something. I think the FAA has not come forward and say exactly what they would do to make sure this doesn't happen again.